Good morning, students. This is Amesh Shende from JS College of Commerce, Vardha. You are watching this lecture of BCA second semester. And today we are going to discuss what is integrity by Subrata Bakhchi. Bakhchi is a well-known name, especially in the industrial area across the world. So before going into depth of this content, what is integrity, this lesson, I would like to give you some outline or some information about this author, that is Subrata Bakhchi. He is actually the co-founder of Mindtree Limited. It is a private firm, a global information technology and research and development consulting company based in Bengaluru. Okay, it's from India. He is also the chairman of Mindtree's Innovation Council and writes a column for Forbes India in which he interviews successful entrepreneurs. The present extract here means this lesson, what is integrity, is taken from his book, a seminal book, The Professional, right? With this title he published a book, and this particular lesson, that is what is integrity, is taken from that particular book. It is a small part of that book, an extract. The extract deals with the basics of integrity. The author has highlighted his childhood experiences, which have gone a long way in instilling, in inculcating the values of integrity in him. Integrity means sincerity, faithfulness, fairness, righteousness, etc. Okay. So what is the gist of this, what is integrity? In just two lines, if we have to sum up this, then it is a lesson, okay, that he learned from his father. So he has given here the information about some general things, some particular things related to his life, his personal life, as well as public life, right? He has learnt a lot of good things from his father. Basically, if I have to give emphasis, then I would definitely like to give stress on one particular thing, that the motivation, major motivation in his life, the main inspiration, the source of inspiration in his life is his father, Subrata Bakhchi's father. And he gives the credit, okay, of his success to his father, because he learnt a lot of things, okay, which I think in general we should maintain in our life. So he learnt a lot of things from his father, Subrata Bakhchi's father. So let's start now. His father was actually a government servant, government employee, public servant, and he was posted at Koraput in the state of Odisha, India. Okay, all of you know that when you are a government servant, class 1 or class 2, that time you are accorded a lot of facilities. Okay, you are provided with a lot of facilities, and you don't have to pay anything for that. You being in that particular position, then definitely government provides you a lot of things, and you can relish, you can enjoy those things. It ranges from manpower, okay, to the instruments, so many things. So the same way, his father, being a public servant or a government employee, was given a jeep or car. Now see, his father was very sincere and very faithful in terms of his own principles, right? He never used that jeep which he was given by the government for his personal use. You'll find a very few people in the world who restrain themselves, who can control themselves from using these things provided by the government. Basically, you know, jeep or bungalow, all these things, right, which are given by the government itself, are for specific purposes only, right? Especially when we speak about the vehicles, especially car, then definitely it is expected from you that you would be using that particular thing, or here jeep or car, for the work related to your office, right? But many a time when you see around you, you'll find somewhat different scenario. Okay, So these things are used for personal use also, and it cannot be said that one is totally faithful, okay, in this particular regard, when that particular person uses all these things for in his personal life, okay. So his father was this kind of person, and that is why in the very beginning of this lesson, what is integrity, he says that he learned these lessons from none other than his own father, Subrata Bakshi's father. So his father was from Eastern state of Odisha, India, and he was posted, as I have already told you, at Koraput. Actually, it is a tribal majority area, Koraput. Okay. Many time Bakshi himself saw that the car was always, I am using this word very deliberately, always parked at the garage only, right? His father very rarely used to fly from his home to the office using that car. Most of the times it was just parked, unused. Actually, if wanted, his father could have used that car in his personal life also. But see what kind of man he was. Okay, so in a nutshell, if I have to sum up this particular thing, that definitely I would like to say that his father was very faithful, he was very sincere, and he was faithful to his own principles. Okay, he lived entire life by his principles, following his own principles, right? The thing that does not belong to you, definitely you should not use that particular thing in your personal life for personal purposes, right? Then in the next paragraph, it's about his brother. The second paragraph is about his brother, Bakshi's brother. Now what happened? When his father got retired, okay, when he got retired from the service, his brother joined the government institution in the position of an IAS officer. He became the IAS officer and he was posted somewhere in India as SDO, Sub-Divisional Officer. So it is the duty of SDO to look after law and order, right? So as he was IAS rank officer, he was given or allotted a government bungalow, the government residence, and definitely servants were also there, okay, in his service. That time also he came across another incident in his life which taught him, he means not Bakshi's brother but Bakshi himself, okay, lesson. So what happened? In the premises of the bungalow, there was a lot of land which was unused for many years. So when Bakshi and his entire family went to live in that bungalow which was allotted to them, here especially Bakshi's brother, because he was an IAS officer and STO. So when this family shifted to that place and started living in that bungalow, Bakshi noticed that that land was lying there, okay, unused. And that's why an idea struck his mind. Okay, he started thinking about the proper use of that unused land. This new concept, this new idea came into his mind, and he shared or discussed that idea with his mother. So what was that idea? The idea was that they would be plowing that land, would be sowing the lentil seeds, and would grow vegetables or other vegetation, right? So all this was being discussed, and his mother also got convinced by him. He was happy. They hired a person and started cultivating that land. So that the intention was good, the purpose was good, but again the principle, P-R-I-N-C-I-P-L-E, principle came into their way. And what was that principle? If it does not belong to you, then definitely you should not use it. So this principle came into their way as a hurdle. Actually, when all this was happening, all of them were happy because they were going to use that unused land, and that also for good purpose only. But something happened. I would tell you it later. So what happened? They hired a man and started cultivating that land. Okay, and they had decided that they would be sowing the seeds of lentil and would grow vegetables, vegetation, would plant trees there so that it can be used for themselves. So one day I proposed and suggested, one day I proposed to my mother that we plow the land and grow some lentils. I suggested we get a tractor from a family friend, and my mother seemed sympathetic. Okay, she agreed with his proposal to the idea. So one day the plowing started. Okay, the next step would have been sowing the lentil seeds, but that was not to be. So why this line is used here? It has some significance in the chapter itself. Okay, what happened next? When his father returned from somewhere, he had gone somewhere, okay, when the plowing of that land or the cultivating of that land had started, his father was not actually present at home. He had gone somewhere outside, and when he came back, he saw and he was literally shocked. He was not astonished or amazed. He was not happy. In fact, he was shocked to see that these people had hired a man to plow or cultivate that land. And again, the principal came into their way as a herder. Okay, it stood in their way of cultivation of that particular unused land as a herder. It was a problem now for them, for Bakshi and his mother especially. When his father came back home, he saw that the cultivation was going on, the plowing was going on. And he says, the land does not belong to us, and who has given this right to you? He was literally giving instruction, stone instruction. Okay, impossibly severe words or harsh words. He was literally giving kind of warning. Okay, he was admonishing him, means here, Bakshi, that the land does not belong to us. We are given, we are allotted this bungalow to live in. Okay, it's because your brother, Bakshi's brother, is an IAS officer, right? He's the SDO. But the land does not belong to us, it belongs to the government. Actually, it was in the periphery of, you know, the area or the wall, right? But instead of that, he did not get convinced that it should be used. He did not like that idea, and that's why he admonished, he warned Bakshi and his mother also, and told them to give up, leave that idea. He stopped that work of cultivation and told very sternly, very strictly, that you should not use that land as it belongs to the government. It is not your property. It is the property of the government. If you want to do that, take the permission from the government itself first. It was just beyond imagination of Bakshi and his mother, and they did not even say anything because they knew well that their father was a very faithful man and was very faithful to his own principles. So this also happened in his life. One incident took place when they had a jeep. They could have used it for their personal affairs, but they could not use it because of their father, as he was very faithful to his work only. Second incident took place when his brother became an IAS officer, was the SDO, right, appointed as the SDO by the government, and they had land. There was many kind of dispute that actually freedom, but his father did not like that idea, and that's why they had to drop the idea of sowing the lentil seeds, etc. Next, he says that one incident took place. It was just similar. Now see, in those days, having mobile was quite even out of idea because it came very later. Okay, but phones were there, right? So as his brother was SDO, the government had given him a phone, and definitely it was for official use only. Okay, and the first time in his life he had seen the phone, he was very amazed, he was very astonished, he was very happy in fact, right? He was very happy, he was pleased from within himself that he was seeing a phone, and he was very eager to use that phone. But again, compulsion was there, again limitations were there. What were the limitations? That it is not your property. Mobile phone also. Okay. It is there only for the official use, so that you should not even touch that. And that's why Bakshi was always under watch of his parents. When I say parents, especially here I note his father, right? So his father was continuously keeping watch on him so that Bakshi does not use that phone. So he was, this was forbidden, okay, prohibited from using that phone. And one thing is given here very clearly by his father, that it belongs to the republic. Republic means state here, right? State means here country or nation. It means it is the property of the nation. It is not your personal property, so that you should be away from that. This was the simple dictum. This was the simple principle, simple precept. Okay, but definitely it was a good thing that his father was instilling these values in his children, and they were growing with the passage of time, and they were learning a lot of things which are very important, significant in our daily life. Okay, if you want to be a good human being, then definitely you must maintain all these things. So he was learning those things at faster pace from his father. Next incident in Bakshi's life. Now his father is just a retired person, his brother is SDO, and he's also well grown up. He has joined a company that is Wipro. Okay, Azim Premji is owner of that company. So today it belongs to Mr. Wipro. I think he is founder of Wipro. Okay, so when he grew up, he studied, got highly educated. He joined the company and got the resident manager, appointed as the resident manager for the US operations for Wipro company. So one day, what happened? This incident took place in his life. What happened? When he was there as a resident manager, one day my most important customer called. He was extremely embarrassed to tell me his thing. Bakshi's thing is, okay, of that one of our engineers was making personal international subscriber dialing, ISD calls. Actually, one day he got a call from his customer, and the customer told Bakshi that one of his employees was using ISD, okay, was using phone for making ISD calls. So it was a really shocking thing for Bakshi, right? Because the phone was for official use, but was being used for personal work. So after that, he says that integrity, okay, now we'll be speaking firstly. What does he mean by integrity? Okay, for him, he says, we follow the rules, first thing. Second, where rules do not exist, we use fair judgment. We apply our own mind, okay. When in doubt, we do not go ahead and do what suits us. We seek counsel. And lastly, he says, finally, faced with a difficult choice, we ask ourselves, can my act stand public scrutiny without causing embarrassment to me and my family? So, he has given these four tenets here, and tries his little best to tell us the meaning of integrity. So lastly, I would like to tell you that use your own brain, use your own mind, have the proper judgment of your own acts, okay, and be sincere or live by your own but good principles, so that those principles are used for the welfare of yourselves also, as well as other people. So this is the lesson. What is integrity? I suppose Bakshi, and we stop here. Thank you.